Good afternoon and welcome to Truro Cathedral. My name is Jerry Mead and I am the organ scholar here. And it's always a great pleasure to hear the Father Willis organ in recital. Today we'll be welcoming Mr. John Challenger from Salisbury Cathedral. And do take note that we will be welcoming him back in 2 weeks on Friday at 7:30 to do the Planets from Hoyt. So we're looking forward to that performance. And he's going to do a little sample of it a little bit today, so I'm looking forward to that. We are grateful to our volunteer stewards in the back, and they really do help make this recital program run very smoothly. If you're interested in volunteering, please do speak to them afterwards. They'll gladly take any extra volunteers. There's no charge for the recital, but we do accept donations. For singles is £5, for couples is 10, but do whatever you feel is right. There are a range of CDs and recordings that you can purchase from our coffee shop just right around the corner if you want to hear some of the choir music that we also do here at Truro. Please turn off your mobile phones. We don't want any extra noises other than the ones coming out of the organ. And without further ado, please help me welcome Mr. John Challenger.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. It's so good to be back in Truro Cathedral. Truro is a deeply special place for me, and I really enjoy coming back every couple of years, or every year sometimes, and not only meeting all of you again, but playing the spectacular Father Willis organ. It really is a very special thing indeed, so I always enjoy coming here. So thank you for welcoming me so warmly. I thought I'd just say one or two little bits and pieces about the music I'm going to play for you today. I'm starting with a short chorale by Jongen, Belgian organist and music educator, composer of course, of lots of beautiful organ music. This chorale I'm going to play for you is just a crescendo really, which doesn't sound terribly flamboyant, but on an organ such as this, starting softly and gradually increasing the volume is a very thrilling thing to do, so I thought it would be a rather good way to start this this concert. I'm then going to play for you a movement from the Planets Suite, which I've been spending this week arranging for your spectacular instrument here. I'm going to play the entire suite in 2 weeks' time on the 13th of October at 7:30 p.m., at which stage you will have your Gaia installation here. So it could be a very atmospheric evening. Please do come back if you can. And then a little improvisation, it's called, by Nadia Boulanger. She is more known as a music teacher and educator than as a composer, but she has a beautiful writing style and a very nice harmonic language. This improvisation is very beautiful and evocative, I think, so I hope you enjoy that. Move over to Germany then. A bit of Wagner opera, which you might not expect to hear in a cathedral, but the Pilgrims chorus from Tannhäuser is very chorale-like and transcribes very well for the organ and was done so by Franz Liszt. Franz Liszt, of course, who was writing lots of large-scale programmatic works for the organ, so it seems right that Wagner and Liszt should combine. And then a nocturne by Germaine Tailleferre. She's not a terribly well-known composer, but she was one of the members of Liszt, which was a French group of composers around about the 1920s, who got together in Montparnasse as a sort of reaction against, I suppose, the rather decadent music by composers such as Wagner. So this is a real contrast. So beautiful little nocturne, quite neoclassical in style. And I'm finishing with one of my favorite pieces by Herbert Howells. Herbert Howells, of course, wrote a huge amount of choral music, and the English choral tradition would be unthinkable without his contribution. He wrote some rather good organ music as well. And this Rhapsody, the third Rhapsody, is dedicated to Sir Edward Burstow. Herbert Howells had spent a lot of time staying with Edward Burstow in York. Burstow had been appointed at York Minster as organist in 1913, I think, and this Rhapsody was written in 1918, allegedly in a one-night sitting during a Zeppelin raid on the city. He was incapable of sleeping, and he composed this Rhapsody in one sitting. So it's a highly charged piece of music, and very forward-looking harmonically, I would say. A very passionate piece, and one that works terribly well on this organ here, so I'm looking forward to that. Thank you very much indeed. If you give me a moment, I shall head upstairs. Thank you.
donations. We hope you can join us next week, same time, same place, and we look forward to seeing you. Thank you.